Martha Kuata, the widow of the late great land rights campaigner John Kuata, led the case here in the federal court sitting in Brisbane. And they couldn't be happier about the outcome.
Yeah, it's a big day for Cape York. It's a really happy day for the people of Cape York that, you know, this wrong has been now righted.
Handing down his judgment today, Justice Andrew Greenwood found the declarations of the Archer, Stewart and Lockhart River basins as wild rivers under the Wild Rivers Act were invalid, agreeing with some traditional owners that the former ALP government made procedural errors, not considering all the evidence when the rivers were environmentally protected.
People weren't informed on the decision. They were in the dark, and we were there to make sure that everybody was informed about, and not only the people of Cape York, but people all around Australia, of the decision that was made by the government without their consent.
Before the last state election, the LNP said it would repeal the laws if it won government.
It's 2 years later. They've been in for 2 years and it still hasn't happened. We went into the last election on a promise, yes, of their repeal. So whilst we acknowledge the assurances that have been given and so on, that, you know, it is just a real testament that at the end of the day, the court victory came before anything else.
Deputy Premier Jeff Seeney says the LNP will continue with plans to repeal the Wild Rivers Act by August.
The Wild Rivers legislation will be repealed in August. It has been replaced already by the statutory regional planning process that is about ensuring that the Indigenous communities have a real say and a real economic future.
Cape York's Noel Pearson says the case was about Aboriginal people having the right to say what happens on country.
Traditional owners should decide whether they want conservation or development or a mixture of both. We want them to make the decision. We don't want this to be unilaterally imposed upon them by political deals in Brisbane. So yes, some of those areas will be open for sensible economic development, enterprises, tourism, horticulture and so on. And some of the areas people will want to conserve for the future. That is their aspiration.
Three Wild Rivers declarations were dealt with here today. That leaves another nine around Queensland, which were declared between 2007 and 2011. Some Murray people supported the Wild Rivers laws, such as Carpentaria Land Council Chairman Murrindoo Yenna and Channel Country traditional owners in Queensland's southwest. Time will tell if they have a choice on what to do with their lands. David Little, NITV News, Brisbane.